A change in comedian Amy Schumer's appearance led to her diagnosis. She suffers from Cushing syndrome. Endocrinologist with UC San Diego Health, Dr. Ekanayake, is here to tell us a little bit more. Good morning, doctor, and thank you for being here today.
Good morning.
From what we understand, it was her puffy face that led to her diagnosis. Explain Cushing's disease for anybody who may not know what this is.
Yeah, so Cushing syndrome, it's anything that leads to an extra cortisol, whether it's from outside the body or inside the body.
How common is this? Is it something that would just randomly happen? Is it triggered by something?
Yeah, so there's two types of Cushing syndrome. One is exogenous, so that just means there's cortisol-like substance, whether it's from prednisone, like prescription medications, or a herbal supplement that has some steroid that is being used by a person that can lead to excess cortisol in your system.
Okay.
And then the more rare kind is the endogenous Cushing syndrome. That comes from typically a tumor, either in the adrenal gland or the brain and the pituitary, that releases extra cortisol.
And is that where the puffy face comes from?
Yeah, so extra cortisol signs and symptoms are not very specific always to Cushing syndrome, but some of them include gaining weight in the midsection, having some extra weight in the neck area or in the clavicular area and the collarbone area, and also the puffy brown face. And those would be kind of progressive and drastic changes for a person who never experienced that before.
Is it genetic? Is it caused by the environment? If there's people watching right now, because you talk about that weight gain, especially in the midsection in here, well, as people get older in life, that's also very natural that would happen. So what would be your red flag or your moment that you say, I should go get this checked or I should talk to my doctor?
Yeah, that's a great question, because you're right. Some of the extra cortisol signs and symptoms look like other things,
yes,
like, you know, menopausal symptoms in women, because there are also mood changes with cortisol excess.
Oh, there is.
Yeah, yes. And there's like brain fog and irritability, insomnia.
Oh, that sounds like my life every day.
Right. So because the symptoms are non-specific, I think, you know, it's important to be kind of in tuned and also talk to people around you to see, like, you know, is this like appearance changing? Is that something that's happening more drastically, dramatically? And it's always a good idea to advocate for yourself and talk to the healthcare provider, because Cushing's does go undiagnosed for a long time, even though it is rare and amongst everything, you know, that we deal with naturally with aging. Cushing's disease endogenously is pretty rare, like 10 to 15 cases per million people.
Oh, that is very rare.
Yeah, but the exogenous Cushing's from medications and supplements with extra cortisol-like substances, that's more common. So in that case, it's pretty easy to stop or wean off of those things. But it's important to kind of have a frank conversation with a physician you follow, you know, regularly, to see, is there something else? Or is this just my, you know, aging or menopause symptoms? Because it's very hard to differentiate. And that's why it gets missed quite a bit.
So let's say you are diagnosed with it and you have Cushing syndrome. What does the treatment world look like for this?
Yeah, so for exogenous Cushing's, like I said, it would be weaning off of whatever you've been on that could be causing it, like high doses of prednisone pills or injections. For endogenous Cushing's, if it's a tumor, tumor is any growth, not always cancerous, but tumor producing extra cortisol, that would require really good connection with the endocrinologist and a pituitary surgeon if it's coming from the brain, and adrenal surgeon if it's coming from the adrenal glands, a tumor producing extra cortisol.
Well, we appreciate you coming by and talking a little bit more about this, given that it's so rare and given that if this didn't happen with Amy Schumer, most people wouldn't even be knowing about this.
Yeah.
So thank you. We appreciate it.
Thank you so much.